When you're cooking for world leaders, it can be really challenging, but equally, it can be exciting. You have a lot of different cultures, a lot of different religions, a lot of different dietaries, but what you've got opportunity to do is to showcase your own food. Previously to coming to the Lensbury, one of my best opportunities was when I was at Sandhurst for over a decade. We got to do lots of banqueting, lots of functions, and of course I had the great honour of cooking for Her Majesty the Queen twice, for Prince Harry and Prince William when they commissioned as officers. This year is the Lensbury's 100th centenary. A great celebration and a really, really exciting opportunity for me to now bring lots of exciting dishes to our members and our visiting guests. I'm not an exec head chef that wants to take a back seat. I want to get involved. And I think you get more respect when you get involved. You can actually develop and train and teach and mentor more of your chefs and your team when you get involved. The dish that I'm going to be cooking is beef and onion. I like my food to sound very, very simple, but in context actually be quite traditional and delicious. One thing that was great with this dish, first time I'd done it was 2012 in Windsor Castle, celebrating the Queen's Diamond Jubilee at the Royal Windsor Horse Show. It was a great dish then. It's a great dish for banqueting because we've done it for 900, so it had to be. And it's a great dish to take forward in any big event or even restaurant fine dining. So we're going to be using a 35 dry aged Casterbridge sirloin, which is absolutely stunning. And we use a particular meat. It's soft, it's well marbled, dry aged with a Himalayan salt wall. And the kind of finished product is so, so tender and so, so delicious. I can prepare it, and the final taste, you would actually think it's fillet. It's that tender and that juicy. The preparation is very simple. We take all of the fat and sinew off, and I call it the naked sirloin, so it has nothing on it. It's very, very fresh. And we cut it into barrel shapes and control steam it at 57 degrees for 3.5 hours. Then roast it in thyme and garlic and lemon, and then cook it through the oven for 10 minutes at 180. Then we rest it and glaze it in a lovely beef gravy. Then with all the trimmings and bones, we make a delicious beef stew. We take all of the beef fat, we render it through the oven with garlic and thyme. And the potatoes, we cut into slices and then cut them into small discs. And once the fat is rendered down, it's taken on some of the garlic and onion flavor as well in the thyme. You pop the potatoes into the oil, which is cooking at around about 160. And then they just soften, but they absorb all of that beef dripping flavor, which is absolutely delicious. And that's the same with the onions as well. So again, all of that you'd normally throw away, we're actually using as a flavor. With some of the dripping, we put it into breadcrumbs with onion powder, and we make a beef and onion crumble. And that combines nice with the carrots that we put onto the dish. And when we finish it with carrot tops, which is obviously the green topping, so we don't waste it again, and some lovely nasturtium leaf, which offers a kind of peppery horseradish finish. When you're working on this particular dish, you really need quality. It's looked after before it even comes to me. You don't want to challenge before you get to that quality. So actually choosing quality ingredients is really, really crucial in getting that result. If you were recreating this dish in a restaurant or a banquet and event, I think it's really, really important that you focus on the minimal wastage, and you're going to have a great dish for your customers. Moving forward, we're going to be introducing some chef specials, which is great because we can showcase the best British quality of products. But equally, it's a chance for me to go to my chefs and say, give me the best traditional British sausage and mash. Do the research, go and speak to the farmer, go and speak to the butcher. But when we've got a real hero dish, to get the chef a little bit more recognition, but also give something back to our members, our families, our guests, is we'll get a little restaurant recipe card printed. And that's something that's important to that chef because it gives them interest, it gives them inspiration, and it makes them feel really proud. And I think if you're at work and you feel proud, you naturally feel good. But then at the same time, give the foundations of that recipe back to our membership and our customers, and let them try it at home. Everyone loves a recipe, especially if it works well.